You watch The Great British Bake Off?
My wife and I love that show. Oh, yeah.
Well, congratulations on Beautiful Boy. I was just saying outside that I went to a gig the night before seeing this, so had like proper post-gig euphoria, and then just had my heart like ripped out at 9 o'clock in the morning the next day. It's obviously such an important film, but I did feel like I had to go home and watch like an episode of The Great British Bake Off to get some kind of like calmness and feel happy.
You watch The Great British Bake Off?
My wife and I love that show.
Do you actually?
Oh, yeah.
You're up to date?
Yeah, I think we watched the finale of the last season. I don't know if we've stopped. Is there a new season going right now?
Wow, I meant that entirely sarcastically.
Oh, no, we're in it. We are in it. My wife turned me on to it. Anyway, we
it's
don't have
perfect.
To.
It's perfect. It's like the perfect,
It is
nice
like a Zen show.
It's
fantastic.
I'm going to get into this.
It's really good.
It's all on Netflix, so you can get properly into it. But yeah, so I felt like I had to watch it to get some kind of like joy. What did you guys have to do when you were shooting it to like kind of get some levity after those particularly draining days, I imagine?
Well, I know you'd just go to theme parks, right?
Yeah, I'm
every
sorry.
Night.
Yeah.
Excuse me. I would go. I have a wife and kids, so we just all watch British Bake Off together. No, just being with them. That was my relief, I think, from the subject matter.
Did you just have to like scream on a roller coaster?
Yeah, no, I didn't go to any.
Oh, okay.
I was kidding.
Oh, well, that
would have
been really fun.
But that wasn't like the Great British Bake Off. I didn't confirm that first. What if I had been like, yeah, that's absolutely
right. Yeah, that's
right.
Exactly what I
thought. You guys know each other more than you think
but,
you do.
No, but I it's one of something that Steve says I really like a lot, which is, you know, and this is true of comedy as well. People in a comedy don't know they're in a comedy. People in a drama don't know they're in a drama. So like you said, there's obviously scenes in this movie that are of a certain intense nature, but I don't think there's anything like particularly you do as a remedy or something. I think on weekends I would try to stay close to Rick and Morty or like silly documentaries or stay away from like intense acting, but generally that's what the material required. And there are a lot of theme parks in California, so no but
yeah, it's just you just sort of live life, I think.
In the film, Nick has obsessions with bands and books when he's a teenager, as we all have had, where your parents say that you're going to outgrow it and you're like, no, this is really important to me. Do you remember anything that you were like obsessed with as a teenager?
I think it's all everything you just said. It's like movies and for me hip-hop and I don't know. Yeah, I feel like my sister and my mom were always waiting for me to get over it. I'm not over it, Mom.
Yeah, I mean, all those, well, pop culture was a bit different when I was growing up, too. But yeah, all those same things. Obsessed, I don't know. I think I took a sampling of everything. I loved comedies. I loved comedic movies. That was, or James Bond movies. That was sort of an obsession. I loved it. That was, James Bond were sort of our superhero movies back then.
And before there were so many of them.
There were so many of them, and we would be online for everyone.
You've said in interviews before that you're obviously a fan of each other's work now. You spent a lot of time together. Do you have a particular favorite of each other's back catalogue?
I like that question.
That you had to say one performance.
No.
Well, I'm partial to his work in this movie, frankly, because I got to see it firsthand. And, well, I will be honest, when he first auditioned, I wasn't familiar with his work, and I have since become very familiar with his work, both on a personal level and what I've watched. But I think what he does in this film is transcendent. He just inhabits this guy, and you never see him acting. It's just it's so natural and raw and real. So I'd have to say this one.
I think it might be Foxcatcher for me, because that is. Thank you for saying that. Thank you.
Well, thank you really. For Foxcatcher.
No, but thank you that. But that is like such a remarkable dramatic performance, and I haven't gotten a chance to tell the story yet. But this feels like an apt moment now, that I would like pick and choose my moments on set with Steve to fan out, and they were very, very few and far between. And it wouldn't be like as raw as I can fan out now, because we're not shooting the movie anymore, so if it creeps him out, like, it won't disturb the chemistry. but I came up to you one day, I don't know if you remember this, and we had been talking about, you know, I think we were either literally talking about Foxcatcher or acting or something, and I said something like, you know, and I just love that that movie and that performance, and it's just this world that, you know, washes over you, Foxcatcher, and that tone is just so cold. And as I said it, I was like, and I saw, and you went, huh, I don't know about cold or something like that. You went, I've never heard it described that way or something like that. And I was like, oh, like, Timmy, watch your words. Like, just keep your mouth shut, man. Like,
you know what? I would agree. In retrospect, like, I hear that again. I'm like, yeah, it was pretty cold.
Okay.
Pretty cold and atmospheric. I get it.
Imagine like you were like, laugh a minute, that film. That would have been a different one.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you both so much, and congratulations on Beautiful Boy.
Thank you. Thank you.